Where's the resistance? Where's the resistance against?
Okay, his Skype just cut out. Let's reconnect with him right now. Thank you. Skype is an incredible thing. Better audio, video, for another dimension of information here, but it still is not perfect. That's why we couldn't use it 3-4 years ago. It was way too sketchy then. Now it's getting really, really good. But I was.
People landed on the moon. But you know what? I don't think people landed on the moon.
No human being ever since the Apollo astronauts has gone more than 400 miles up.
That's about right, yeah.
That's ridiculous. 260,000 miles there and back, and the best they can do since 1972 is 400 miles?
Yeah. And now, while you're saying it's ridiculous because you can't believe it, I think it's ridiculous because I can believe it very well.
But there's it's not like they're not spending money. And they keep talking about going back, but they talk about going back in 2020. Why go back in 2020 when you could just... But that's the other problem. They don't have the telemetry data from the Apollo 11. Isn't that like the most important data? Isn't that like the most important thing? A huge technological achievement. They landed a man on the moon, brought him back, and they're missing the telemetry data? 14,000 something reels?
They're missing... A lot of that stuff was not...
Because you can't fake it. Because you can't fake it. You can't fake the telemetry data.
One of the things that's most irritating about this conspiracy theory for someone like me is that a lot of this stuff is really subtle and complicated. And
14,000 reels of telemetry data for the most technological achievement in human history that's not stored in the Smithsonian Institute, it's not stored in NASA vault, it's not labeled, it's not under lock and key, it's not in a gold vault. There's nothing weird about that.
I can't say anything about 14,000 reels. I don't know the number. And so,
yeah, it's
true,
like 13,000 or 14,000. I forget. Either way, it's more than 100, which is crazy. You've lost more. If you lost more than 100 of the telemetry data, that's insane.
On the moon, there's no atmosphere. The meteorites rain down on everything, on anybody who happens to be there, any equipment on the surface. Had astronauts gone to the moon, they would have been pelted and pierced by micrometeorites traveling up to 30,000 miles per hour. One wonders why they were able to get such perfect photographs on the moon when obviously micrometeorites could have gone right through the Hasselblad cameras and the film. You know, Bart, I really know so little about that. Renee is such an expert that I'll beg off on that point because I know little or nothing about the radiation in space, but he has it down absolutely cold.
Tell us about the, what about the air conditioning in the lunar module?
Oh, yeah. Well, I can talk about that. The lunar module on the moon was assailed by sunlight, unobstructed by any atmosphere. The surface of the moon, when the sun is shining on it, is about 250 degrees Fahrenheit. One has to ask, how were the astronauts able to air cool or water cool or cool in any way the interior of the lunar excursion module? They only had batteries, and batteries run down very quickly when they're running air conditioning equipment. So it's obvious to almost anybody who investigates the lunar excursion module that there would have been no way to keep the astronauts alive in an environment that was hot enough to bake cookies.
Grissom and his crew boarded the Apollo 1 capsule for a full-scale simulation. The problems began almost immediately. First, the capsule's communication systems failed.
You copy? No, I didn't read your check at all. I can't read your check. You want to try the phone?
How do you get the moon? We can't find the green tree floating.